remember, send the position. Legs up, Brendan. Stay on the play area.
All their brain power went into figuring out which leg to stand on. They got the correct legs in the air, but it was all downhill from there. Brendan gets through by cheating and dropping his leg. Jason decides to play it fair and lose, a mistake many of his rugby league mates never make.
Teamwork here. Get on that right angle there. True, get on the angle of your legs.
I'm no doctor, but I diagnose that Cindy's gluteus maximus is the problem here. Cindy's medical training made that hop easy. When in doubt, hop on your partner's back. The shape was right, but the position was wrong. Obviously, two brains are not better than one.
Wall! Pick him up, Candace. All right, easy. They're going to get through here. Woo! That was.
In weightlifting circles, this is called the clean and jerk. You work out which is which. Candace just had to pretend she was a barbell. Obviously, not too much of a stretch. He bench pressed this piece of brawn straight to victory.
On offer, and trust me, you need them. It's time to face the wall.
Come on, Carl.
All right, think about it, Carl. You're meant to be the brains.
Come on.
Lift up your arms.
Oh, looks good, looks good.
Most people could do this one standing on their head. It takes a special skill to make a trained gymnast look uncoordinated, but Carl is up to the task. When you've got Carl holding you by the ankles, you know you're in trouble. In they go.
Oh! You gotta get through, 1 point a player. What are you doing? Hey, lift her up, Joel. Oh. Floss.
Cindy Pan looks like a ninja doing the haka here. These brainiacs have bitten off more than they can chew. Not since Steve Spielberg last played Hole in the Wall has Jaws done this much damage. They're like lumpy dental floss trying to get through the teeth. All they were thinking was jump, but the wall said no. The brainiacs will have to think again.
The Mega Wall. Lucky that wasn't you, Finn.
Quickly.
Come on. Figure it out. Go to the same hole.
Drew makes the mistake of thinking Cindy actually knows the answer to something. The brainiacs can't do simple arithmetic. But the answer is they've lost. Dr. Cindy's diagnosis of this problem was fatal. She was dead certain about the wrong answer. And once again, brawn wins over brain.
Stand by, jump.
Think like a lollipop. Think like a lollipop. I got my money on Adam.
These guys are used to lollipop shapes, but eating them, not fitting through them. It's like three sumo wrestlers facing their worst nightmare, a hole in the wall. The two sumos who had to squat were fine, but the one that had to stand up got wet. Remember, these guys are not used to sudden movement.
You can swap positions. Uh-oh.
One hole was too big, one hole was too small, and one was just right. Guess which one Shane picks? Three little bears, but one little hawk. Didn't know how to make it through. Forget Goldilocks, it's wetlocks for Shane.
That's easy. You sure you want to do those positions? Maybe you want to swap. Triple speed, remember?
They all leant forward, but there was no room for their butts. You can bend all you like, but when your rear is bringing up the rear, the wall is bringing you down. Jason makes it through. Brendan and Candace decide to make their own hole, all the way to the pool.
Hey, I'll swap spots.
Let's go straight to the replay. This is bad parenting. Mummy and Daddy were fine, but the kid did not make it through. For some reason, Carl decides he's the man of the family. And Drew shows another flaw in the one-child policy. It's always the kid that gets hurt.
Come on, guys. Come on.
Adam decides he'll try to fly away, but he's never going to get off the ground. Jordan is squatting, which is a position he'd be more familiar with. It's Jordan that makes the break. All Adam has to do is stay on his feet. Always a tough ask. This is one of the few times when the wall actually lost. And so did Adam.
Oh, that... another flashback, Adam? Don't break it, Ludi. Do not break it, I'm telling you.
Oh! They had to think faster than a lizard drinking. A couple of leaping lizards. Matt looks surprised that he got through. Well done, Ludi. That's using your head. When hole in the wall becomes an Olympic sport, these two are ready.
Hey, Jono, get that leg up. Jono, get it up. No points, get it up. Another look.
First problem. These two don't need any help to waddle. Second problem. They both needed to get their legs off the ground. And that doesn't happen very often. Neither of them managed to get a leg over. Not a surprise to anyone, really. Flipping heck, one of them makes it through. It's not quite happy feet, but it's a step in the right direction.
If you spill one drop of that, you lose your tip. It's time to face the wall. Quick, get down. Get up.
Ludi decided early on that the drinks would be on her. The glasses are a problem. Matt doesn't like to wear glasses. Ludi is a glass half full sort of girl, but she has to go into the pool to half fill them. All those drinks in the drink. Code is for failure. This is a surprise result. Shane has had lots of experience hopping through bars. That's exactly the way Shane goes through a bar and leaves a bar. The wall wasn't going to have a bar of it. In he goes.
Get through there. Alright!
These guys are not the first things to be splattered on this wall. Here's the first problem. They each had to get their weight off the ground. The problem is the holes are not massively overweight. They did all make a jump for it, but one of them didn't even get off the ground. That last 100 kilos let them all down. This result may inspire these three to get off the couch, if only to look for chips under the cushions. It's all over for these wallflowers. Victory to the sports stars.